services, no one ever sits in the front. Welcome to this incredibly special service on our journey towards Easter. It is a unique service, so enjoy as we sing and praise God and as we journey towards the cross. You get to hear the voices of Ayden Christian Church, Winterville Christian Church, and Hooker Memorial Christian Church. I'm the minister here at Hooker Memorial. Anthony, back far, is the minister at Winterville Christian Church. And Chad, who is big and tall with beard, is upstairs with the baby. Sorry, she's a little cranky. We are grateful for all who are able to come and join us today, and we ask that you just enter into the presence of God and reflect and pray throughout this service. Let us turn.
Thank you. was the first day of unleavened bread, and the disciples came to Jesus asking, "Where do you want us to make the preparations for the Passover?" Jesus said, "Go into the city to a certain man and tell him, 'The teacher says, my appointed time is near. I am going to observe the Passover with my disciples at your house.'" The disciples did as Jesus had instructed them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When the hour came, Jesus took his place at the table, surrounded by his disciples. He said to them, "I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. I will not eat it again until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God." He then took a cup, and after giving thanks, said, "Take this and divide it among you. For I tell you that from now on I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes." He then took a loaf of bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he did the same with the cup, saying, "This cup, poured out for you, is the new covenant in my blood. Remember me."
Surely not I.
Jesus replied, "Yes, it is you." Later that evening, Jesus told his followers, "This very night, you will all become deserters." But Peter declared, "Even if all the others fall away, I will never desert you." "Truly I tell you," Jesus said to Peter, "before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times.
Thank you.
place of prayer to find his disciples sleeping. "Get up," he said to them, "for my betrayer is at hand." While he was speaking, Judas arrived, accompanied by a large crowd with swords and clubs. Judas came up to Jesus and said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus said to him, "Friend, do what you came here to do." Immediately they stepped forward and seized Jesus. He said to the crowd, "Have you come with swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I sat in the courts of the temple teaching, and yet you did not arrest me. But all of this has taken place so that the writings of the prophets may be fulfilled." Then all of the disciples deserted Jesus and fled.
Thank you.
said to him, "If you are the Messiah, tell us." Jesus answered, "If I tell you, you will not believe me." Then they asked, "Are you then the Son of God?" He replied, "You are correct in saying I am. What further testimony do we need?" they said. "We have heard it ourselves from his own lips." Then they brought Jesus before Pilate, but Pilate said to the chief priests and crowds, "I find no basis for a charge against this man." But they were insistent. Pilate, after learning that Jesus was under Herod's jurisdiction, sent him to Herod. But finding nothing for which to convict him, Herod sent him back to Pilate. Finally, Pilate said to Jesus' accusers, "I have examined this man in your presence and have not found him guilty of any of your charges. Neither has Herod, for he sent him back to us. He has done nothing to deserve death." Then they all shouted, "Away with this man, release Barabbas." Pilate, wanting to release Jesus, addressed them again, but they kept shouting, "Crucify him, crucify him." The shouts of the crowd eventually prevailed. Pilate finally granted their demand. He released the one who had been imprisoned for insurrection and murder, and he handed Jesus over to them as they desired.
Justly and are getting what we deserve.
but this man has done nothing wrong. Then he said, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus answered him, today you will be with me in paradise. It was now about noon, and darkness swept over the whole land. The curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus cried out in a loud voice, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. When he had said this, he breathed his last.
Children of earth, how beautiful.
The centurion, after witnessing what had happened, praised God and said, "Certainly this man was innocent." When the crowds who had gathered there for the spectacle saw what had taken place, they were deeply saddened as they returned to their homes. All those who knew Jesus, including the women who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance and watched these things.
Thank you.